By doing that, the pupils will be more aware.
Wah, apa juga?
One of the good things that the activity was very interesting. It actually allows the pupils to expand their creativity. And another thing, his bonus point, like, he's a very humorous person, so pupils will like him. Yeah, that's the thing. And then the activities is actually another part. It's something like a formative assessment, because you can see whether the pupils know what is eye, what is mouth. So it's like you already assessing the students. And for room of improvement, just only one. Maybe you can, because in a classroom we have new students and advanced students. Maybe for new students, they should only draw maybe 3 out of 5 stuff on their field. Maybe for the advanced, they can draw more. That's it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, all right.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Assalamualaikum and very good afternoon to our friends here. Please look at the next slide.
Hello, thank you.
Write down your 5 top tips for golden rules about planning language art lessons. Okay, please look at your D5S2.5. Your handouts. D5S2.5. Okay, write down your 5 top of golden rules of planning language art lessons. Okay, I give you 5 minutes to write down tip number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You can discuss it with your friends. Actually, I don't know what it's about. So I will plan on this session after this. You can discuss with your friends. Okay, you can start now.
Okay, yang bawah kena tunggu tadi. Okay. Kosong 66 duduk di DJ dan duduk di DJ. Jalur DJ itu adalah jalur sedikit. Satu jalur ada dua sifat, iaitu nama itu satu jalur sifat. Kenapa dia ada dua kali? Jalur sedikit itu adalah jalur sedikit. Jadi, satu dia ada dua sifat. Jadi nama berapa apa ni?
Thank you. I'm going to go to the next one.